First year MBBS is a little difficult, it's a little challenging also. If I just remember my first year days, the day when I first came to Maulana Azad Medical College, New Delhi, it was my first time ever I was coming to Delhi and I had to live all alone by myself. And it was quite different from what we used to do in our All India PMT preparation or maybe your NEET UG preparation. In the NEET UG preparation, we used to just sit whole day in our home doing MCQs, reading theory. And here, I had to take care about my clothes, I had to take care about my food, I had to go to college in the morning, 9 to 4 class jao, subah jaldi jaldi utho, khud utho, and it was quite difficult. And like after 4 o'clock, you used to just get exhausted and you used to just sleep till 10 o'clock in the night. So yes, it happened with me. I used to sleep 4 hours every day in the first year MBBS. I used to get so much tired. And in the NEET UG days, there was someone who was looking after you in the home. If you are living in the hostel, even if you are living in Kota or anywhere else, you were always consistently being asked that mari padhai kaise chal rahi hai, that you are doing good or not. But as soon as you enter your college, your parents don't ask much about your studies. They think that you have grown up, okay, and you can manage all these things very well. So because things are not easy, so many things are happening. We are not able to manage our studies well. We are not able to take care about our health, about our food, and we are not able to attend the college classes well. That is why, guys, here I am today. I am Dr. Himanshu Gupta. And I will be guiding you, I will be helping you like your elder brother to sail through the first year MBBS, not smoothly, but definitely better. I will be guiding you through my experiences of my first year as well as my experience of the MBBS. I will be sharing with you few tricks and tricks that will definitely be helpful for you in your first year MBBS. So guys, in this video, I will be targeting more about your studies, how to manage this anatomy, biochemistry and physiology. And if you want me to talk about other topics like how to take care of your health, how to attend your college lectures well, and how to manage your extracurricular activities along with studies, then definitely you can write to me in the comment section below. And I will definitely make my future episodes on these topics. So guys, before beginning to tell you about your studies, I want to tell you something about myself, that I have been guiding students for the past 3 years to help students get a good rank in the postgraduate entrance exam, that is your NEET PG, AIIMS and PGI. It is through my experience of interacting with so many students, I will be sharing these tips with you. And I will be sharing these insights with you guys. So guys, what I have seen that in the first year MBBS, we have too much to read. What we were reading in our 11th and 12th class, it is quite different from what we are reading now. And two subjects, physics and chemistry, are totally gone. These were the conceptual subjects in which we just have to like memorize few formulas and then apply them onto the numericals. But here we have so many books like Gray's Anatomy, Guyton, Harper, and it takes a lot of time in the beginning. It takes a lot of time in the beginning to read them word to word. Many of the students, what happens with them, they will get scared. Initial 3 to 4 months, they will get scared reading these books, and ultimately they will give up. Ultimately they will give up and they will just open their books 2 months before the exams. So guys, I want to tell you one principle. That one principle will definitely help you sail through your MBBS very smoothly, very smoothly. You have to do this basic task. I will call this as a basic task that you have to do daily after coming from your college. And I want to tell you the principles that you applied for your NEET UG preparation, the same principles are valid for your MBBS also. I want you to remember your initial days of your NEET UG preparation. You must have realized that in the beginning 3 to 4 months of your preparation, the physics, chemistry and biology seemed too much for you. and it was too difficult as compared from what you were reading in your 10th class. The same is the situation here. What we are reading in the first year, it is quite different from what we used to do in the 11th and 12th class. So guys, initial months are tough. Here we need to be patient. Okay, here we don't need to think too much ki I'm not understanding anything, nothing is going into my head, I'm not able to remember anything. Here we just have to keep on putting our efforts, like you were doing in the initial days of your NEET UG preparation. So once you have just overcome this period of 4 to 5 months where you are consistently working hard, you will see with time you will get used to these subjects, and I can tell you that you will start falling in love with the subjects also. You will start falling in love with the subjects if you are reading good books like Grey's Anatomy, Guyton, Harper. And let us just assume once that you are having problem in going through your MBBS, going through your first year, or reading textbooks like Guyton, Grey's, okay? Guys, I want to tell you that you are living in the best era. You have various mentors available with you on YouTube, on Telegram, okay? Nowadays, you have various online platforms available with you. If you are having trouble reading the books, understanding the books on your own, you can go for online platforms like Marrow, PrepLadder, and I talk about them in detail in the end part of the video. And if you don't know how to read these standard textbooks, you can have a look at my video also, in which I have explained in detail how you have to read a standard textbook. Okay, so guys, we cannot give any reasons of not doing well. Okay, we cannot give any reasons of not doing well in this era. I want to talk about that basic task. What is that basic task that will help you sail through your MBBS very smoothly? So guys, you all know this principle, but my only job is to remind you of that same principle, because now you will not be looking to your NEET UG mentors. Now you will be looking to someone who can guide you, who has already done the MBBS and who can guide you through his or her experiences. And guys, that basic task is consistency of 2 to 3 hours daily. 2 to 3 hours daily in your hostel, in your library, if you just devote 2 to 3 hours daily to studies, okay, that will be the like ideal way to spend your MBBS. You know, you might be thinking that if I'm just devoting 2 to 3 hours to the studies, I will not be able to read all my books, I will not be able to complete my lectures, okay, what the teachers have taught, or I will not be able to complete my practical files. But guys, these 2 to 3 hours, I'm not asking you to do for like 1 month or 2 months. I am asking you to do it consistently over a period of 5.5 years. Just remember this fact, 3 hours over a period of 5.5 years. And let me tell you a few benefits of doing this. What is the benefit of doing this? As we go into our college days, we like to have some fun also, okay? We like to do parties, we like to devote some time to the extracurricular activities, we like to go to gym or any other activity that you like to do, okay? So if you want to do other things as well during your MBBS, you have to do this basic task. So let me just give you an example. If you just fail to do this basic task of like studying daily, what will happen? You will lose your interest, okay? Because you will get low marks in your class test. You will be having various vivas with your professor. You will not be answering. Then definitely you will not have a good mood after not answering the questions, after being insulted by your professors. When you have a low mood, okay, you will definitely lose your interest in your MBBS. I pray that it does not happen with you, okay? If this happens, then again, your exams come, you have just 2 months remaining for your exams, and if you are just trying to do everything in the 2 months, you will not be able to understand the concepts, you will not be able to memorize the facts, and definitely there are chances that you fail the exam also, and then your stress level again goes up. So we don't have to fall in that situation if we are watching this video, okay? we have to devote some time daily to the studies. And let us see, if we are in a situation, if we are just devoting 2 to 3 hours daily, what will happen? What will happen is that we are managing our studies well. We are doing good in our studies. Results may not come initially in the initial 6 months, 7 months, 8 months, but they will definitely come. And besides that, we will have some time to do our extracurricular activities also, and we can do them without any stress. Okay, we can watch a movie every Sunday with our friends. We can socialize well, and definitely we will have a good name, a good respect among the students also, because we are reading well and we are definitely doing good in our MBBS. So guys, hope you have understood this concept about consistency very well. Let us discuss what should be our mindset during our MBBS, what should be our goals in our MBBS, and what should be achieved by the end of this first year MBBS. So guys, just remember the hard work that you are doing today, the struggles that you are facing today, that will save someone's life 5.5 years later. Just keep this in mind, that you have to be the greatest doctor in India. If you have some role model, I would ask you that you paste the photo of that role model in your room. You can have role model like Naresh Trehan sir, okay? Become a cardiovascular surgeon, and these things will definitely motivate you to stay up a little longer, to listen to your classes, college lectures actively. And this was like your goal, okay? This was your goal that you have to achieve. You have to become the greatest doctor, okay? This should be your only goal. Now, how you can achieve that goal? What should be your target, like for this first year? I want to tell you, your target should be that for every subject and every unit, you have to try to understand that topic, okay? Memorization should not be your first aim. If you are just able to understand every topic, to understand a topic, you will have to read that topic from a standard textbook, and you will have to spend some time with your books. Don't worry about remembering things, okay? You will gradually be able to remember them. But focus on understanding every topic, every unit of all the three subjects. This should be your only aim. See, even if like 2 months before the exam, you have just read all your books, you have understood everything very well, okay? In 2 months, you can just revise everything to write something in your exam. That will never be a problem. But if you are just cramming things from the first day itself, and if you are not spending too much time on understanding things, okay? So then you will never get the time. You will never get the time to understand the same things. Okay, to spend so much time after your first year MBBS. So this should be your primary target if you want to do well in the first year MBBS. Coming to what books you have to read during your first year MBBS. So guys, I will advise you that 3 books, Guyton, Gray's Anatomy and Harper, these are must, okay? I know these are very big books, these are very lengthy, okay? And these will be constituting at least around 4,000 pages, okay? But I want to tell you, your Truman of Biology was also not short. That was also very big. But you guys managed to read that book, okay? So you don't have to think about that whole book. You have to think about the 10 pages that you have to read daily, okay? If you manage to read 10 pages daily in the 3 hours of the basic task that you are doing, you will be able to complete all these 3 books. And this should be your main focus, ki yaar ye 3 kitabe hame 3 saal mein acche se padhni hai. Now guys, coming to the teacher's lectures. I feel that I had missed my teacher's lectures. They were wonderful lectures, but it is because of my fault. I was not able to attend them properly. I was not able to make notes properly. And I want you guys not to do that same mistake. So guys, the teachers in your college, they teach amazing, okay? So what you learn from a teacher, you will definitely not learn from a book. What a teacher will teach you, what a professor will teach you, it will be like a combination, it will be a collection from like various resources. He will be covering at least around 10 resources, 5 resources, and he will be explaining you all these things in a simple way. So it is very important that you attend your morning lectures 8 to 9. And how you can be attentive in those lectures? So guys, I will just advise you 2 points. So first point is that if you can get to know what the teacher is like going to teach the next day, try to read few points about that topic. If you can do this, definitely you will be more attentive in that lecture, okay? You will be able to listen to that lecture in an efficient way. And second advice that I want to give you is that sleep on time. What my problem was that during the MBBS, you know, I used to come back after the college, I was very tired, then I used to sleep for 4 hours, 3 hours in the evening, and then I was not able to sleep till 3 o'clock or 4 o'clock in the morning, and so this way I used to miss a lot of my 8 to 9 lectures. So I want you guys not to do that mistake. So these two ways will help you attend your morning lectures or your professor lectures very well. And now guys, coming to the online platforms, many of you have been asking me, sir, which online platform do we have to go for? So if you are towards the end of your first year, or if you are someone who has just recently given the first year exams, so definitely you can start looking for various online platforms. And I will advise you one of the online platform that I love, and it is Marrow. So it has a great collection of videos from all the 19 subjects from the best teachers in India. And it has a good question bank also that you can start solving at this moment of time. You can start solving 5 questions, 10 questions, or whatever that you can manage. You can start solving questions from the first year subjects which you have just given exams of, and that will be easy for you to solve. And once you get used to this online platform early in your preparation, that will definitely help you to sail through your MBBS very well. And coming to your next preparation, so guys, I want to tell you that asking for a next preparation in the first year is like a student in the 8th class who is asking, sir, how to prepare for NEET UG. Okay, so at this point of time, I will advise you, just read your subjects very well, whatever subjects that you are reading. Try to solve the online platforms, and if you want to ask any question related to fun, related to exercise, related to relationships, I would definitely ask you to write down in the comment section below, and I would definitely answer all your questions. And till then guys, meet you in the next episode. I will definitely pick up some topic that you have mentioned in the comment section. We will discuss about that. All the best.